Hello everyone, I'm Ankur Chaudhary, and as far as this video presentation is concerned, I'll be covering current affairs from 1st February 2018 till 15th February 2018. So these are the broad areas I'll be covering the news items from. First, let's start with awards and honors. Firstly, India's Umang app won the best M government service award in the accessible government category, while Aadhaar won the Best Emerging Technology Award at the 6th edition of the World Government Summit 2018 in Dubai, where India had the status of Guest of Honor country. Now, Umang app, as some of you may be aware, is a single app through which you can access large number of services provided by the government. Next, Prime Minister Narendra Modi was conferred with the Grand Collar of the State of Palestine by President Mahmoud Abbas for his key contribution to promote relations between India and Palestine. Now, the Grand Collar of the State of Palestine is the highest award given by Palestine to a foreign dignitary. Now, the visit by the Prime Minister was also historic because it was the first formal visit by an Indian Prime Minister to the State of Palestine. Next, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, former Liberian President. Liberia is a country in Western Africa. He was honored with the 2018 Ibrahim Prize for Achievement in African Leadership for Excellence in African Leadership. Now, the Ibrahim Prize has been set up by the Mo Ibrahim Foundation, which is based in a country called South Sudan in Africa. Now, this particular award is given for great achievements in African leadership in promoting democracy and development in their respective countries. Next, Mr. Jayant Madhav Bora was conferred with the 2017 Sahitya Academy Award for Assamese Literature for his novel Moria Hola. Now, the Sahitya Academy Award are the highest awards for literature given in India. Eminent Kannada critic T.P. Ashok was selected for his 2017 Sahitya Academy Award for Kannada language for his literary criticism, that is Kathan Bharati. Next, Mr. K.P. Ramanunni from Kerala was conferred with the 2017 Sahitya Academy Award for Malayalam literature for his novel Devathinte Pustakam. Next, Mr. Shesh Anand Madhukar, an eminent Magahi, or the language is also known as Magadhi. This language is spoken in vast areas of Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand and West Bengal. An eminent Magadhi writer and scholar was honored with the 2018 Sahitya Academy Bhasha Samman Award. Now, as far as Sahitya Academy Awards are concerned, for the 24 major languages of India, it is given separately. For all other languages beyond the 24 languages, the Bhasha Samman Award is given. Next, Shyam Benegal, the noted film producer and director, was bestowed with the prestigious V. Shantaram Lifetime Achievement Award 2018 for his contribution to the promotion of the documentary movement. The V. Shantaram Lifetime Achievement Award is given by the Mumbai International Film Festival for lifetime achievement in cinema. Next, we look at some important news from business. Firstly, the 12th edition of International Conference on Corporate Social Responsibility was held in Bengaluru in Karnataka with the theme Responsible CSR, A New Agenda Beyond Governance. Next, Google launched a new online security campaign called Security Check Kia in India to promote security awareness among general public. Next, NCERT, that is National Council for Education, Research and Training, it signed a pact with Google to integrate a course on digital citizenship and safety in information and communication technology curriculum. Again, this course is also related to promotion of digital security awareness among the public. Next, Hardayal Prasad was appointed as MD and CEO of SBI Card. Now, SBI Card is a joint venture between the largest bank in India, that is State Bank of India, and an American equity firm called the Carlyle Group. SBI Card provides all kinds of facilities, infrastructures to various banks in the countries like debit card, credit card, etc. Now, it has a customer base of over 5.7 million and a market share of 16% in the country. Next, we see some important news from politics. Firstly, West Bengal became the first state to opt out of the National Health Protection Scheme unveiled in the Union Budget. The NHPS, that is the National Health Protection Scheme, was announced by the Finance Minister, Mr. Arun Jaitley, in this year's Union Budget. Now, under this scheme, around 500 million Indians would be covered by quality health insurance coverage, in which the premiums will be paid by the central government, that is the Government of India. Next, the India-Russia Agriculture Business Summit was held in New Delhi, with the two countries discussing trade relations in the agriculture sector. Next, Defence Ministry constituted a 13-member advisory project committee to monitor and expedite capital acquisition projects for the modernization of the armed forces. It will be headed by Shri Vinay Sheel Oberoi. He was a former secretary in the Government of India. Such committees are very important as far as your exams are concerned. So you would do well to remember the name of the person heading the committee and the objective, that is modernization of the armed forces. Next, the Uttar Pradesh government launched a massive door-to-door campaign called Dastak in association with UNICEF to eradicate the deadly acute encephalitis syndrome and the Japanese encephalitis diseases in the state. Now, these two diseases are cause neural disorders and can prove to be fatal as well. They become prevalent during the monsoon seasons in the states of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. Next, the Haryana government launched the Gobardhan Yojana to provide for the sale of organic manure and cow urine with an aim to benefit the farmers. Next, the central government announced a 1.4 lakh crore Kusum scheme. Kusum stands for Kisan Urja Suraksha Uthan Maha Abhiyan. Now, the Kusum scheme is targeted to promote decentralized solar power production. So basically, the central government would be giving subsidies or grants to farmers to install small solar panels or small solar plants within their fields or their homes. Next, economy and finance. Firstly, Kerala, Punjab and Tamil Nadu were the top rankers in Niti Aayog's latest health index report, with Kerala topping the list. As far as the large states are concerned, Uttar Pradesh was at the bottom. Now, this particular report, the health index took into consideration various large number of health indicators in a state. For example, maternal mortality rate, infant mortality rate, the percentage of spending done by a state on health sector, and so on and so forth. Next, India was ranked 44th out of 50 countries in the 6th edition of Intellectual Property Index released by US Chamber of Commerce Global Innovation Policy Center. Now, as far as this index is concerned, a low rank that India has got depicts that India has very poor standards of intellectual property protection. Next, in the Union Budget 2018, Finance Minister announced the government's plan to build a tunnel through the Sela Pass. Sela Pass is located in Arunachal Pradesh at an elevation of 13,700, which will ensure faster movement of troops in Tawang, which is a strategically located town in Arunachal Pradesh bordering China. Next, India joined the Ashgabat Agreement, which envisages creation of an international transport and transit corridor. This is important, international transport and transit corridor connecting Central Asia with the Persian Gulf. Now, by joining this particular agreement, India will seek to enhance trade connectivity and movement of goods between India and the Central Asian countries of Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, etc., as well as the Gulf countries in Asia. Next, Mr. Jairam Thakur, the Chief Minister of Himachal Pradesh, launched zero budget natural farming project to promote organic farming in the state. Now, the zero budget natural farming, as the name suggests, includes farming which does not use any kind of fertilizers or any kind of pesticides. Next, China remained the world's largest steel producer in 2017, according to a latest report published by the World Steel Association. So at the top is China, then the next steel producer is Japan, the third largest is India, and the fourth largest is the USA. Now, India has only this year overtaken USA to become the third largest producer of steel in the world. Next, we look at some important people making the news. First, renowned Pakistani lawyer and human rights activist Miss Asma Jahangir passed away at the age of 66 years. Now, Asma Jahangir, in 1987, she founded the Pakistan Human Rights Commission and was a staunch critic of the military establishment in Pakistan. Next, Mr. Bishwa Mohan Mahapatra was appointed as the non-executive chairman of the National Payments Corporation of India for a period of 2 years. Next, Professor Chandrasekhar Kambar, a noted Kannada writer and Gyanpeeth winner, was elected as the new president of the Sahitya Academy. Now, the Sahitya Academy is the official academy of letters in the country. Its objective is to promote literature in the local languages of the country. Now, although it is not directly under the government, but it is supported and funded by the government of India. Next, Mr. Dinesh Srivastav, a distinguished scientist, took over as the chief executive of the nuclear fuel complex. Now, the nuclear fuel complex is the agency which provides nuclear fuel to various nuclear power plants in the country. Next, Dr. Harshvardhan, the Union Minister for Earth Sciences, launched a 2.8 petaflops capacity high performance computer system called Mihir in Noida to improve India's weather forecasting. Now, petaflops is a unit of the measurement of processing speed of any computer. Let's look at this term first, that is FLOPS. FLOPS is a acronym or a short form for floating operations per second. Now, peta is a unit like mega, giga, tera, etc. So when you talk about mega stands for any unit, that is 10 raised to the power 6. After mega comes giga, which is 10 raised to the power 9. After giga comes, of course, the tera, that is 10 raised to the power 12. After tera, we have peta, that is 10 raised to the power 15. After peta, we have exa, that is 10 raised to the power 18. Next, Ms. Indra Nui, the PepsiCo chairman and CEO, was appointed to the International Cricket Council board as its first independent female director. Next, Mr. Khadga Prasad Sharma Oli, the chairperson of Communist Party of Nepal, that is Unified Marxist Leninists, was sworn in as the 41st Prime Minister of Nepal by beating the ruling Nepali Congress. Next, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Exam Warriors. It is a book that he penned to reach out to the students across the country ahead of their exams, was launched in New Delhi. Next, Neelam Kapoor was appointed as the new Director General of the Sports Authority of India. The Sports Authority of India is a premier agency of the Government of India involved in encouraging sports activities amongst the youth. Next, Mr. Sudeep Lakhtakia took charge as the new Director General of the Black Cats Commando Force, that is the National Security Guard. Next, we look at some news from sports. Firstly, Haryana emerged as overall champions at the inaugural Khelo India School Games. So the Khelo India program was launched last year by the Union Sports Ministry to revive and encourage the culture of sports in schools in the country. Next, India won the 12th edition of the ICC Under 19 Cricket World Cup 2018 after thrashing Australia in the final match. Next, Julan Goswami, India's veteran pacer, became the first female cricketer in the world to take 200 wickets in women's ODI or one day international cricket. Next, Miss Sharmila Nicolette from Bangalore became the first Indian golfer to qualify for the China Ladies PGA Tour. Next, Shubhankar Sharma from Chandigarh became the highest ranked Indian golfer after securing 72nd position in the official world golf ranking. So again, in such kind of news, the ranking of Mr. Sharma is not important, but it is very important for you to remember that Shubhankar Sharma is related with golfing. Next, Tamil Nadu beat Manipur to lift their maiden title in the 23rd edition of the Senior Women's National Football Championship. Next, we look at some miscellaneous news items. Bermuda became the world's first country to first legalize and then repeal same-sex marriages in the country. Next, the 6th edition of the World Government Summit 2018 was held in Dubai, that is in United Arab Emirates. Next, the World Cancer Day, this is important, was observed on 4th February with the theme We Can, I Can. Next, the World Leprosy Day was observed on 28th January with the theme Zero Disabilities in Girls and Boys. Next, India's first ever radio festival was held in New Delhi on February 15, 2018 to mark the World Radio's Day. The festival was organized by International Association of Women in Radio and Television in partnership with UNESCO. Very important, India's first online radio station, that is Radio Umang, was launched on this day. Next, India's financial capital, that is Mumbai, was named among the top 15 wealthiest cities globally, while New York topped the list as per a report by the New World Wealth. Next, Mr. Rajnath Singh, the Union Home Minister, launched the Center for Learning Sanskrit Language in Gujarat University. This will be the first of its kind spoken Sanskrit center in India. Next, the National Yunani Day. Now, Yunani is a system of medicine, which is a combination of systems of medicine from Persia, that is erstwhile Iran, and Arabic. Now, this particular system was highly influenced by the Greek scholar, by the teachings of the Greek scholar called Hippocrates. Right? So the term Yunani itself stands for Greek. Yes, so the National Yunani Day was celebrated on 11 February to mark the birth anniversary of great Yunani researcher Hakim Ajmal Khan. Next, the first ever Pelican Bird Festival 2018 was held at the Attapak Bird Sanctuary on the Kolleru Lake in Andhra Pradesh. This bird sanctuary is the home of thousands of pelicans that migrate to this lake. Next, the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, in collaboration with Department of Forest of the Assam government, organized national level celebration of the World Wetlands Day on February 2nd, 2018. Now, February 2nd is celebrated as the World Wetlands Day because on the same date in the year 1971, a very important international agreement was signed known as the Ramsar Convention. Ramsar is of course a city in Iran in which this convention or agreement was signed. As per Ramsar, the Ramsar Convention brings together a number of member countries in order to share knowledge, towards further protection of wetlands like swamps and mangroves in the world. With that, I come to the end of this presentation. I hope you find this helpful. Thank you so much.